Good mathematical morning.
Because mathematically,
it's always morning somewhere in the world.
True. Right now, at this very moment.
On to this month's challenge. This month's challenge is, drumroll please.
Challenge.
Oops. What happened to our screen?
I've never seen him do that before.
We're experiencing technical difficulties.
Do you know how to fix it, Heather?
I've just never seen it go like that before.
Doesn't that remind you though of like when you're... Like a television set? Do you guys... Are you sure it's not on like a setting that's different than... Like what if you shut it off? Like hard... Turn it off and back on again. Or should we just keep pressing buttons on the remote? Well, I mean, maybe... We've tried every remote so far. Oh, that beeped. That could have been it. That's the projector.
Due to technical difficulties, we now bring you 8 animated shows in a row.
About a great math teacher, his name is John.
Math teacher John.
A head full of mathematical knowledge, math teacher John.
I'm teacher John.
One day, while he was walking down the street, skip counting.
2, 4, 6, 8, and 10.
And by fives, he was also skip counting.
5, 10, 15, and 20.
I'm just an asteroid floating out in outer space, trying not to break my pretty face. Here comes a rock, I'm breaking up, and now I'm just a bunch of meteoroids. Oh no. Being pulled towards a big planet sphere thing, don't you know?
Meteoroids are small pieces of rock or metal that break off a comet or an asteroid when they crash into each other. When these small pieces of rock are pulled into Earth's atmosphere, they are called meteors. The meteor heats up and burns, which makes them red hot. If more than one of these meteors burn up, then you can see a meteor shower. Millions of meteors enter the Earth's atmosphere every day. However, very few of them reach the Earth's surface as a meteorite.
Smart and swell, I know all that. I bet that others wish they knew these facts.
His brain knows this, his brain knows that. A brain so full, a brain so fast.
Meanwhile, high above the stratosphere,
there is a meteor out of control. It's flying through the air, and it's spinning in the most peculiar way. Now here, gravity is pulling me towards a sphere.
One day, while John was walking oh so proudly, reciting high digit song.
3.14159265358978, and on and on.
Just then, as he was feeling oh so dandy,
and on and on, 9323 and beyond.
The meteor raced towards him oh so fastly, collision course, no doubt of that.
It raced towards him, falling very fast, collision course, there is no doubt of that.
It raced so fast,
collision course, there is no doubt of that. And then it hit him on the head and squished his big red flat.
Ground control to Mr. John. All the numbers inside your head are gone. Ground control to Mr. John. Memory meltdown, knowledge gone. Students, help your teacher John. He was hit by a meteor, now his memory's gone. Help him to find the pieces of his mind so we can put them back. We'll put them back together, back where they belong.
This has been Math Videos with Tate and John. Tune in next time to hear John say,
"Wow, these videos are great. I'm learning a lot."
Circle. It's a square.
On a sphere. A cylinder.
A T-Rex shape.
1 times 1 is 1.
2 times 2 is 4. It's on a door.
3 times 3 is 9. Up in Rubik's cubes all the time.
4 by 4 is 16.
5 times 5 is 25.
Taekwondo 15 life.
Exactly
90 degrees. This is 90 degrees. There's many other right angles a robot can cut the phone. Yeah.
So you start here, you start at 0,
like 128.
Every hour, 30 degree angle. 30, mm-hmm. 60, 90, 120, yeah. 150. Mm-hmm. You could go every quarter, is it 90?
Every half is a 180.
Go for it.
Slide.
Hi there, it's Dave. We are going to count by 25 with these piles of rocks right here. 25, 50, 75, 100.
30, 60, 90.
I just took them from the 8 and split it from 5, and I took the 3 away from it.
5 plus 8 okay. equals 14.
And then 2 plus 1.
Yeah. 257 minus 38. Now 1 from the 5, so 13 take away 8. Plus 9 plus 8 equals 3 equals 1. 2 plus nothing equals 2.